What is going on, guys? Rodney here with cryptobros. Welcome to tonight's video. We're going to be taking a look at the Brave browser and basic attention token. If you haven't looked at the charts today, we can see there was a big surge in price and movement in price action, up 28% currently. So big news actually came out on the basic attention token in terms of their partnership. We'll cover all that in just a minute. If you guys haven't had a chance to subscribe to the channel yet, I would absolutely love to have you as a subscriber, covering everything from ICO reviews to coin project reviews, news, taxes, if you name it, I'm trying to cover it. Certainly appreciate the subscriptions and the likes that you guys are tossing out there. Keep being awesome and know that I do appreciate it. All that being said, let's jump into today's video. We are going to start out with what the Brave browser is. I'll tell you that I downloaded this like a month ago. This is something I've definitely wanted. I just didn't fire it up until the last couple of days. And in, you know, coincidentally, big news came out today. This is what's driving the price action, but it says, you know, Brave partners with Dow Jones Media Group to test blockchain solutions. And you can right here download the Brave browser for free. No different than using like a Google Chrome, Firefox, or Safari. And actually, if you guys do want to download it, I do have a referral link below. It just is a small way of showing your appreciation for the CryptoBros channel. I get like a $5 kickback. $5 kickback in basic attention tokens if you use my referral link. If not, just go to brave.com and you can download it there. Highly recommend either way you watching this video, just to kind of give you an idea of what it's doing. It's like a minute 30, but anyway, so let's talk about it really quick. So why did I download this this browser? You know, right here their big push is in terms of A, you can browse faster, and B, it saves money and time over the course of the month. This wasn't the thing that drew me in. Really why I'm so bullish, I guess, on this browser in particular is because one, we are blocking advertisements that we don't want to see, and two, we are blocking trackers from getting our data. And I'll cover that a little bit more in a minute. Here they kind of make their push on, you know, saves you hours each year. We get it, but here's the big thing for me. So Brave blocks ads and trackers, reducing your chances of being infected by malware, ransomware, spyware. And that says in 2016, infections increased by 132%. Brave even has HTTPS upgrades, which means more of your connections are encrypted, protecting your identity, browsing, and payments. And if you guys know anything about me, I'm a freak about that stuff. Definitely use the VPN. Now using Brave browser, just trying to make sure that my data, my privacy is mine and it does not leak anywhere. And you can actually see right here, popular sites host as many as 70 trackers. The Brave blocks that software that follows you around the internet. What's pretty cool is like once you download this, and this isn't like the Apple iTunes store, so it's an approved upon application, which makes it super cool, easy to download like anything else. But you know, in terms of today, 182 trackers blocked, 230 ads blocked, 23 HTTPS upgrades, and 21 seconds of time saved. Very, very cool. So that is kind of like the Brave browser in a nutshell. That's why I like it. That's why I think this is going to kind of be a more prominent and maybe even openly adopted browser, especially with the news. As we kind of mentioned, Dow Jones Media Group partners with Brave software to offer premium content to users and test blockchain-based payment technology. Just a quick blurb from here. It says the two companies also aim to collaborate and experiment on blockchain-based technology in media and advertising. They plan to test a number of innovative solutions in the news information space, including and delivering content via Brave's blockchain-based digital advertising services and digital advertising services platform. Under the partnership agreement, Barron's and Market Watch will become a verified publishers on Basic Attention Tokens platform and developed by Brave. So if you do decide to use the Brave platform, you get a 2-year subscription to Barron's, which is valued at $497, and a 1-year premium newsletter from Market Watch, which is a $198 value for a 2-year subscription. Very cool. Those are just random bonuses. But then within the article, talks about, you know, Dow Jones and the Brave software. Obviously, there's a couple other groups that also have, you know, CNET has an article out, Bitcoin Magazine, Reuters. So all these different things are out there. Very cool news. Obviously, the driving factor in today's price action on there. If we just kind of swing over to CoinMarketCap, we'll do a quick run through of the token metrics. 1.5 billion total supply, 1 billion circulating, all-time price, high price of 90 cents, current price point 35, ranked number 55 in CoinMarketCap at $356 million. So overall, very cool project in terms of Brave Browser. Now let's kind of just dive in and check out the Basic Attention Token. You know, here's their website. This is basicattentiontoken.org. Totally check out this video. Their head honcho is a former creator of JavaScript and then the co-founder of Mozilla and Firefox. So him and his team are very well endowed in this space. You know, very cool project in terms that it's open source, transparent, decentralized, efficient. I get it. Those are very big buzzwords, but you know, worth checking out anyway, just for the fact that it is fairly cool. This is a ERC-20 token. I was gonna go through this white paper here in terms of you know, token user applications, just so we can get a better idea on that. But I can actually sum this up in a much shorter version that is less painful and easier to digest. But here it just kind of talks about the challenges that each party has. So really what Basic Attention Token is doing is, one, they're trying to help the user by protecting them from crappy things that happen on the internet, from their data being sucked up, from malware, infections, viruses, stuff like that. But right here it says the abusers, so guy or the abused, people like you and I. It says up to 50% of the average user's mobile data for ads and trackers is costing as much as $23 per month. Basically what it's saying is that ads and trackers that are on the websites we are on are sucking up more data than actually viewing the website itself. Ads use about 5 seconds of mobile load time on average. Ads decrease phone battery life by 21%. Blah, 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 blah. So we get it. Not super great from a user base. It's also saying the publishers are hurting. Think like Google and Facebook. You know, they take 73% of all ad dollars and 99% of growth. Revenue is down 66%. Bots inflicted $7.2 billion in fraud last year. Over 600 million phones and desktops run ad blocking software, which is becoming obsolete. And publishers cannot seamlessly monetize value added services anymore. And that's because they can't track what the data is or the effectiveness of their advertising, which leads me on to the advertisers are losing. So again, they don't have a good grasp on what they're paying for. You know, their advertisements, it's very, and there's a couple other projects that are also working on a very similar outlay of this in terms of, you know, digital advertising. They want to make sure good advertisements are getting in front of the right people. It's not mass blasted, so they're losing thousands of dollars in, you know, marketing costs for ineffective marketing because it's not getting to the right audience. So then it says, marketers are often fooled by bogus websites and bots that commit fraud, and then targeting is poor, making users more likely to ignore ads. And I think most all of us can identify with that. You know, the internet and most of the space is just over inundated with advertisements that you don't even see it anymore. It's white noise. So anyway, what they're trying to do, we've already covered the Brave browser, but they want to make this Brave token, you know, usable for a publishers and advertisers. So if you're putting out good content, you can get, you know, you can get the BAT token as a kickback. And then also as like a user like myself, I can sign up to see advertisements that particularly pertain to me. So it's not like I'm seeing like, I don't know, Barbie doll advertisements. That was a terrible example, but you know, it would be stuff that pertains to me, and the browser kind of anonymously tracks that. So A, you're seeing less advertisements, but the ones you are seeing, if you sign up to do that, are more, you know, likely to be tied to you. So anyway, we'll just kind of quickly read this. It says, Basic Attention Token can be used to obtain a variety of advertising and attention-based services on the Brave platform as it is exchanged between publishers, advertisers, and users. Now it's just talking about the coin, being circulated around. We'll pull up a quick video and I'll show you this in like 5 seconds. But then it says the token's utility is delivered from or denominated by user attention. And it says attention is really just focused on mental engagement on the advertisement in this case. So really all they're basically saying here is if you're putting out good content and you're engaging someone and you have my attention, you can actually get a kickback for that for publishing the good content. Here they just kind of combine the two together. The Brave browser knows when users spend their time, making it the perfect tool to calculate and reward publishers with basic attention tokens. This service creates transparent and efficient blockchain-based digital advertising market. Publishers receive more revenue because middlemen and fraud is reduced. Users who opt in receive fewer but better targeted ads that are less prone to malware, and advertisers get better data on their spending. So it's kind of like their little three-piece pyramid here and how it all ties together. User, advertiser, publisher, you know, you got your blocking out the crap, you're getting in the good. I guess we don't necessarily need to break this down, but to kind of give you guys an idea of what is going on here, this is like a 5-second clip from that video on the front page, but just quickly share it with you guys. So,
problems in the current ecosystem.
There we go.
Publishers will receive tokens when ads are viewed. Users also get a share for their attention if they choose to receive ads. From that share, they can then donate back to publishers they wish to support. We also see publishers being paid in tokens, able to back to publishers they wish.
So again, as a user, you can turn on your ads, collect tokens. As a publisher, if you like the content they're putting out, you can donate back to these guys. So we have like this whole kind of circular or pyramid effect here in terms of the use case of basic attention tokens. Obviously kicking back tokens to publishers demands better content, vice versa. So that is kind of the basic attention token in a nutshell. And really, like, if we think about kind of where this space is going in terms of many different aspects, privacy, advertising, all these different things. Just kind of look at what's going on in the news like right now, especially when we're talking about privacy. Like, we've seen all this stuff with Facebook. I am really struggling to talk right now, but we've seen all this these issues with Facebook lately, right? The whole thing with like the facial recognition and the privacy aspects. Like, you know, it's been in the news, and I think this is only going to be a bigger issue, especially when we're talking about what they're doing with our data, and this is one way that we can protect it. So anyway, guys, overall, you know, that's really all I have for you tonight. I think the Brave browser is pretty fantastic. Again, if you guys want to download that, you can. That link is below. Feel free to use it. If not, you can go to brave.com. You can get it there. But other than that, man, that's all I have. I do sit on just a small bag of BATs, and happy to see the price surge. But you know, that's a huge partnership that they've taken on, and I think we'll see some good stuff with them long term. Anyway, I didn't get a chance to jump in the team, but I don't want this to go too terribly long, so we'll just kind of wrap it up. Here's the guy that we're looking at right here. Created JavaScript, co-founded Mozilla and Firefox. Obviously, this is, and if we just kind of do this quick glance before I wrap this up, like, this is like a pretty hearty team. There's a lot of people involved in making this happen, and you can totally check out all they got going on. BasicAttentionToken.org, Brave.com. Check it all out. Anyway, guys, if you found any value in this video, would absolutely love to have you as a subscriber. Toss me a like if you like what I got going on, and that's it, guys. Have a great night, and I will check you later.